Well, welcome everybody to the Ganang Ice Arena here for Gangwon 2024 Winter Youth Olympic Games. And we're here for the women's single short program. Saw the men's short programs yesterday. It was a very exciting competition, and we hope for very much the same here today. My name's Graham Bell, and I'm joined in the commentary box again by Petra Bindle. Petra, what can we look forward to from the women today?
I think, especially in the last two groups, we have some really, really good skaters. Especially, I would say, or mention this Mao Shimada. She won twice the Junior Grand Prix Finals. She's the current Junior World Champion. And we have the Jia Shin, the Korean woman. She was twice second at the World Juniors and twice second at the Junior Grand Prix Final. I think they are maybe the top contenders. But there are a couple of more skaters who really had great results so far this season.
Yeah, so it could be a battle between Japan and Korea. Of course, many nations will be represented. And we've got three groups of skaters that will come out.
One had to withdraw, so in total we have 17 skaters to watch now in the short program, the first part of the ladies' competition.
So we'll have five in the first group of the short program, and they will be coming out. And you can just see them coming out now. And we'll have their warm-up coming up very shortly. We're going to have an ice cleaning after a resurfacing after this first group. And then we'll press straight on through to the final, what is it, 12.
Yes.
Of course, these athletes will have warmed up off ice before they even come out onto the rink. And here's the start list. Sienna Kazmarczyk from Australia will get things underway. Yves Dubec of France. Lena Ecker of Hungary. Shiki Gao of China. And it is actually the Cypriot that is missing that won't start and will go all the way through to Inga Guganidze of Georgia, who will be the last to skate. Yeah, the off-ice warm-up, as important as the on-ice warm-up. They'll have warmed up before they even put the skates on. Shiki Gao from the People's Republic of China there, very diminutive. Tiny. Nervous faces there.
But I think it's no surprise because it's a very big competition. A lot of people are in the arena. And these ladies, they are still very young.
It's time to introduce this first group out onto the ice. Sienna Kazmarczyk from Australia.
France 선수입니다. Representing France, Yves Dubec.
Yves Dubec from France. Lovely little curtsy there.
Representing Hungary, Lena Ecker.
Lena Ecker from Hungary.
Representing People's Republic of China, Shi Qigao.
Shi Qigao from the People's Republic of China.
Israel, Sophia Shiffrin.
And Sophia Shiffrin representing Israel.
Skaters, you have 6 minutes time for your warm-up.
So 6 minutes warm-up before we get the action underway. And we can chat a little bit about the athletes as they prepare. Seeing a Kaczmarczyk from Brisbane, Australia.
The third at the national junior competition in Australia.
Has a PB in the short program of 38.62.
Ranked fourth place in the 2022 Asian Open Figure Skating Trophy. Representing Australia, Sienna Kaczmarczyk.
Her best result this season was a second place at the Oceania International Figure Skating Competition.
And Yves Dubec of France from Reims.
Taking pictures and riding. Representing France, Yves Dubec.
PB of 45.58.
17 years old.
From Hungary, Lena Ecker, skating out of Budapest.
She is a skater who likes drawing and painting. Plays 16.
You heard it. She loves to draw. She loves to paint.
Junior Grand Prix Cup of Austria.
43.45 her PB in the short program. Shi Qigao from the People's Republic of China.
This is our 14-year-old.
Competed in two Grand Prix this season.
In the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix in Budapest.
Budapest 8th place and 9th place in Gdansk.
Yeah, and 60.40, one of the better in this group. From Tianjin in China. Lives in Beijing. And last but not least, Sophia Shiffrin of Israel.
Place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix in Bangkok, representing Israel, Sophia Shiffrin.
So these are the five ladies we are about to see now with their short program, and they have to present seven required elements in the short program. In 2 minutes and 40 seconds, plus minus 10 seconds, so a maximum of 2 minutes and 50 seconds. We always say in a short program an axel, so here it is a double axel. The junior ladies are not allowed to show a triple axel like the men yesterday. In the seniors competition, of course, it's different, but we will see some triple axels in the free skate, especially from the Japanese woman, Mao Shimada.
We'll see a few triple lutzes.
Yes.
Triple loops.
Yeah, so they have to show a double or triple lutz, and of course the jump combination, a double-double, a double-triple or triple-triple. Of course, the better ones we will see definitely a triple-triple one. Then we have three spins. We have a flying spit spin. Then, of course, I think we see a lot of laybacks or sideways leaning. Or they can, of course, choose a camel spin without change of foot. And then we have a spin combination and a leveled step sequence. So these are the seven elements they have to show now in their short program.
warm-up이 종료됩니다.
Skaters, there is 1 minute left in this warm-up.
Warm-up 시간이 모두 끝났습니다. 선수들은 모두 퇴장하여 주시기 바랍니다.
Skaters, your warm-up has ended. Please leave the ice. Representing Australia, Sienna Kazmarczyk.
Sienna Kazmarczyk from Australia will get this competition underway, skating out of Brisbane. And she will be skating to Burlesque Express by Christina Aguilera and Babylon Welcome by Justin Howitz.
She starts with a double lutz. Triple loop and then the double toe, but the loop was already a bit underrated, and then of course she couldn't execute the double toe. Oh, she's in the kind of the change foot combinations there. And now she is in the step sequence, and all step sequences should be executed according to the character of the music. And it's important to fully utilize the ice surface. And of course, we have different levels. From level one, that is minimum variety, up to level four, with complexity, with difficult turns and steps throughout the step sequence. Flying sit spin, one of the seven elements. What's missing is the double axel. And then will we see a layback spin? A minimum of 8 revolutions.
And the Australian, Sienna Kazmarczyk, gets things underway.
Yeah, she decided not to show the triple lutz like planned at the beginning. Maybe she does not feel comfortable. Then, of course, it's better to use the double, because they can show the double or the triple
And then the triple loop double toe was not a double toe, was it?
No, and already the triple loop was under-rotated. She will get some points, but of course for this element some negative GOEs because she couldn't execute the combination perfectly.
Well, she has a personal best score, a PB of the in the short program of 38. Here we go. This was the...
Yeah, you see. And then she opened the double toe. Nice spins, by the way. We have here four levels too, like I already said with the step sequences. For the flying sit spin and for the layback, it's always a minimum of 8 revolutions. And no problems with the double axel. But she's happy with her performance. No bigger mistakes, no falls. That's what we see a lot here in this competition, a lot of hearts.
And the scores coming in for Sienna Kaczmarczyk. 39.97.
It's a PB that's perfect for her.
Yeah.
Representing France, Yves Dubec.
Skating out of Reims in the Champagne region of France, it's Yves Dubec. Can she produce a sparkling performance? The music, horror piano theme.
The triple loads.
It's a shame.
She opened up after 2.5 rotations, so. The combination was really lovely, triple loop, double toe.
Thank you. Well, recovered well after the fall on the triple Lutz.
That was a really bad fall. That hurts just from watching it. But good that she could continue skating, because then she came back strong with a nice triple a double combination.
So there will be deductions for the fall. As
and the jumper we downgraded to a double.
Yeah, so let's have a look at the replays. No problem with a double axel to start things off, but this was the Lutz.
Wow, that was really a bad one. She landed on the wrong edge. Nice variations here at the combination spin. Yeah. Triple loop, and then the double toe.
Into the step sequence, and then the layback spin to finish things off.
Best result the season so far for Eve was the fifth place at the Trophy Metropole Nice Côte d'Azur. And here she is with her coach, Malika Tahir, and waiting for her results for the show program at the Youth Olympics.
Well, she's got a PB of 45.
That's good.
47.69, so takes the lead.
And a new PB for her.
France has earned 47.69 points.
Part of the fall, but
first place.
Hopefully she has now. Or is pain now after this fall?
Representing Hungary, Lena Ecker.
Skating out of Budapest for Hungary, it's Lena Ecker, and she will be skating to perhaps by the Pussycat Dolls.
Pussycat Dolls was after the 80s, or? I'm not sure anymore.
You won't admit you love me, and so how am I ever to know? You always tell me, perhaps. A million times I've asked you, and then I ask you over.
Triple flip, double toe.
If you can make your mind up, I will never get started. And I don't want to wind up.
Some problems with the landing after the triple looks.
If you really love me, say yes.
Perhaps. Last element, the layback spin. And it's done.
Nice theatrical finish there from Lena Ecker. And a big smile from the skater from Budapest. Skating to the Pussycat Dolls. And a little bit of trivia. Kimberly Wyatt from the Pussycat Dolls competed in the UK version of Dancing on Ice a couple of years ago.
With you at the same year? No.
I skied with her, actually. I know Kimberly well.
She has a PB of 43.45 points from the Junior Grand Prix Cup of Austria this season.
So let's have a look at the slow-mos.
Yeah, she changed. Normally she planned a triple Sarko double toe. She showed a triple flip double toe. And then here, it was under-rotated to Lutz, and then she couldn't make it with the landing perfectly.
But avoided the fall.
Yeah. When it's just a quarter, then it's just negative GOEs. When it's more, when it's maybe half of a rotation is missing, then it's downgraded to a double. But she played with the audience. That was really lovely in her program.
Yeah, lovely choreography. Good theatrical performance.
And she just turned 15 years old at the beginning of this year. Very young lady.
And goes into second place with a score of 44.93.
That's a new PB. The next one. Great.
Brings her to second place. Representing People's Republic of China, Shi Qigao.
From the People's Republic of China, Shi Qigao. From Tianjin. And she will be skating to the Gladiator soundtrack.
What a big music for a 14-year-old girl. But she's the first to plan a triple-triple combination. So let's see. It's the first element of the show program. Triple, triple, triple toe, triple toe. It was really, at the beginning, a nice triple Lutz, a great height, but then she couldn't make it. But look at these spins. These spins, amazing. What a show.
Yeah, big music and a big performance. Are you not entertained? The theme from Gladiator has been well performed by this young woman.
She just turned 14 in October. Just a young girl, but she has this natural talent. Really lovely. I'm completely impressed about this young lady. It was amazing. Okay, maybe these problems in the landing with the triple lutz, but everything else and the spins, all level four, absolutely amazing. And the step sequences, the deep edges, she really uses her knee and nice turns. And she played with the music and with the audience. That was incredible.
Yeah, big, and big that was, performance.
And I'm completely impressed because she has an amazing height. There's no under rotation. Very often the
and
small
the double skaters, axel, yeah, looked like she had so much time.
Yes, and normally the small skaters, they often have problem with the height, and then you have to watch twice in triple, is it fully rotated or not? But no problems here. And look at this, like, and here.
Yeah, that was the only mistake.
Yeah. An amazing talent China has with her, with Shiki Zhao. Of course she will be in the lead now with this performance.
Well, she has a PB of 60.40.
Yeah, yeah.
I think.
You already mentioned in the warm-up that she has the best PB in this group.
Yeah. So we think this is the lead.
Yeah, it must be. Because we saw this triple-triple,
yeah,
and the spins and the quality of the steps that was outstanding in this group so far. And with the triple lutz, I would say she would have been a contender for the top five.
Question is, how big is the score? 60.28.
Yeah, almost her PB.
Takes the lead by a long way. Twelve and a half points ahead of.
Yeah, would have been around 63, maybe with a nice landing of a triple lutz, but very good.
Representing Israel, Sophia Shiffrin.
Sophia Shiffrin, representing Israel, will skate to "Bad Guy" by Billie Eilish.
Triple flip, triple toe. Triple lutz, all jump elements done. Thank you.
Sophia Schifrin.
Quite an impressive performance when it comes to the jumps, especially the triple flip, triple toe combination.
And I like how the outfit matches the music as well.
Yeah, Billie Eilish always is very, I would say, extrovert.
Jumps were good?
Yeah, very good.
A good performance from Sophia Schifrin, who has a PB of 53.07, and I think she could be pretty happy with that performance.
And she is 14.2, so, and in this age often you have differences. Some maybe, when we see her maybe in 2 years, then of course her artistic flair is even better than now. Some like the skater before, they already have it maybe when they were born. But to see these effortless triple-triple combinations already at this age, that is always very impressive. This was the Lutz. Ah, it was slightly under-rotated.
Managed to pick up an awful lot of pins, hasn't she?
Yeah.
Coach is wearing her accreditation there, and she's definitely been on a pin collecting spree.
That's what we did. I remember when on the World Championships in Munich, and we got a lot at the end. My jacket was full of them because everyone gives you one.
So the scores. There's a big gap between first and second, and we're expecting Schifrin to fill that gap. 49.54.
Yeah, and it's about the components, and it's fine because the Chinese woman, she got 26.51. It's almost 4 points difference in the components.
But just ahead
and the spins, of
Eve Dubeck,
yeah,
who's now pushed down into third. And that wraps up our first group. As we see Shiki Gao of China with an impressive score of 60.28. That could be good enough to set her up quite nicely for the free program in a couple of days' time. We're going to take a break from commentary now because we have a ice resurfacing. The Zamboni is coming out and it'll be 20 minutes or so before we're back underway with groups 2 and 3.
참석에 참석해서 관람해 주시길 부탁드립니다. 또한 경기가 시작되기 전에는 우리 선수들이 경기에 집중할 수 있도록 조용히 해주시고 경기가 시작되면 뜨거운 응원을 부탁드립니다. 감사합니다.
Well, welcome back, everyone, to the women's single skating competition in the Gangwon Ice Arena.
Representing Japan, Yo Takagi.
The next six ladies here on the ice.
Representing Chinese Taipei, Yu Feng Tai. Canada 선수입니다. Representing Canada, Kaya Reuter. Swiss 선수입니다. Representing Switzerland, Anthea Gradinaru. Representing Republic of Korea.
First of the Koreans that we will see tonight, Jia Shin will go second last and is in the final group. So let's have a look at this wave.
On fresh eyes.
Sofia Sepchenko from Latvia, hometown Riga.
Yeah, she's got a 13th place at the last Europeans, already had an 11th last year. So very well experienced.
PB of 58.87.
And had a first place at the Latvia Trophy in Riga.
Yo Takagi of Japan.
She was a substitute for the Grand Prix final. Just missed it with a fourth and a second place at the Junior Grand Prix. Very good contender.
ISU Junior Grand Prix Osaka. Representing Japan, Yo Takagi.
Yeah, the Japanese women are very well known. They have amazing skaters like the world champion Kaori Sakamoto
from Chinese Taipei.
She is a 14-year-old skater.
It's Yu Feng Tsai.
Third place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Osaka, representing Chinese Taipei, Yu Feng Tsai.
Another third place at the Junior Grand Prix in Osaka, you heard it.
And 61.52, her PB in the short program. Out of Calgary, it's Kaya Reuter.
And she is the Canadian champion in the seniors category. So at the moment, the best Canadian skater.
Kaya Reuter has a PB of 63.17. And you just heard, she's a big Oilers fan. The Edmonton Oilers. Born in Ottawa, lives in Calgary, but supports the Oilers.
Yeah.
Say it.
Fifth place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix PGE Solidarity Cup, representing Switzerland, Anthea Gradinaru.
Anthea Gradinaru of Switzerland, born in Zurich.
Second best Swiss skater at the moment.
This 14-year-old skater has placed second place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix in Budapest, representing Republic of Korea.
12월에 slightly missed it to the final with the second and the fourth place in the Junior Grand Prix.
Kim from Korea, out of Seoul. About 3 hours drive to the west of here. Has a PB of 63.04, does the Korean. One of the best in this group.
And they are now in the middle of the warm-up for the 7-11s they have to present in their short program. In the lead so far, the Chinese, Shiki Gao, after really an impressive program.
But these young women have the skills.
Of course.
And the scores to better that.
Yeah.
And this is just the second group. We have a third group to come.
But we already mentioned this young woman who is in the lead, actually, with a perfect triple Lutz. She would have had a PB2. So, easy start with a single axel. A double has to be executed.
Some skaters like to do everything in the warm-up and others like to save it for the actual competition.
They just skate around and just to get a feeling.
Yeah.
Skaters, there is 1 minute left in this warm-up.
And they normally don't really hear what the coaches are maybe screaming or talking or whatever during the warm-up. They are in their routine. They know what they have to do and when they're on this level. She looks really cute. Another very young skater here in this competition.
Skaters, your warm-up has ended. Please leave the ice. Latvia 선수입니다. Representing Latvia, Sofia Stepchenko.
Sofia Stepchenko from Latvia. And she will be skating to All Eyes on Me.
With her 162 centimeters, one of the taller ones here in this group. Triple flip, double toe. It was planned triple, triple, but better like this. Really nice. Lots of the skaters, they show their step sequence, maybe as the last element or the sixth element. She is already doing it at the second after the jump combination. In earlier days, we had a fixed pattern like a midline or a serpentine or a diagonal or a circle. Now it's just fully utilized the ice surface. good choice with the triple lutz now in the second half, because she get a, if it's fine, she gets a bonus for it. Ah. Ah, unfortunately a fall. For the base value, she still gets the bonus, but of course she gets a deduction now for the fall.
Well, it's a shame that the fall came on the triple lutz.
And of course, you see it in her face that she's not 100% satisfied, but that is, of course, normal.
Yeah, disappointment there for Sofia Stepchenko of Latvia.
I like the music. It was really a good choice here for the short program. Combination, very nice triple flip. Then she struggled a bit, and it was a good decision just to show a double and not a triple toe afterwards. No problems with the double axel.
Yeah, shame.
It was fully rotated. That's why she will get the full points for the lutz, for the triple lutz. But, of course, the deduction and the negative GOEs. So she's losing a couple of points for it.
Well, there's a huge gap between first and second. 60.28 is Shiki Gao of China in first. Sofia Shiffrin in 49.54 in second place. As we await the scores for Sofia Stepchenko.
Yeah.
Fifth place with that deduction, 44.77.
And just 21.52 points for the components. That made a difference too.
Representing Japan, Yo Takagi.
That's now quite interesting, this young lady.
So has a PB of 63.42, skates out of Tokyo. Yo Takagi of Japan will be skating to Sous le Ciel de Paris by Edith Piaf.
Triple toe, triple toe. Very nice double axel. Really love the speed of the Japanese skaters. Notre Dame.
paname tout peut s'arranger. Quelques rayons se perdent à donner, il entraîne à confier.
Yeah, wonderful.
Voilà, c'est ça. Allez, riez, Milord. Allez, chantez, Milord. Ta da 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 da. Allez, venez, Milord, vous asseoir à ma table. Il fait si pour moi dehors. Ici, c'est confort.
Perfect music. The audience is clapping.
Mais vous pleurez, Milord, ça je l'aurais jamais cru.
A very, very good skate there from the Japanese Yo Takagi.
Yeah, I was already expecting it after her season so far. They have so many great skaters. I mean, you see, she's just the 23rd of the seniors competition in Japan and the fourth best junior in Japan with that performance. And that just shows that they have so many incredible skaters in Japan. All with an amazing technique and skating skills.
And great choreography, good music.
Good, it was good choice, very thing. Deep etches, gliding over the ice, and the speed.
La Vie en Rose. Well, pick the bones out of this. Triple, triple.
It's not the most difficult triple-triple, but it was very well executed. And look at this double axle and the speed when she landed. That is important too, not just the speed before the jump. Spins on a very high level, and here the triple looks no problems.
Well, do we have a new leader?
I think so.
That is the question. 60.28 is Shikigao of China.
I would say it should be because this program was without any mistake and very well executed. It should be the lead.
Just look to have that flow and confidence.
And so lovely to see her smiling here. Very, very good short program. Had the perfect start for her to the Youth Olympics. Yes, of course. Whoa, what a lead.
Yes,
and what
67,
a
67.23. It's a personal best for Yo Takagi and comfortably in the lead.
And well deserved.
It's taken us to a new level. Yufeng Tsai from Chinese Taipei will be skating to... This is the second Billie Eilish song we've had. Copycat is her music.
Committed, I'm in crime, push my button.
Combination in the second half with the bonus, triple salvo, double toe. Not the most difficult one, but very well executed. Yes, another flawless performance.
And she finishes with a layback spin. And what I particularly liked is that she went up to the judges there.
Yeah.
And just as Billie Eilish was singing Psych,
yeah.
And she's like playing for the judges. Very good choreography. But you said the triple salco, not as difficult as the triple
flip
loop.
Or the loops.
And the double toe loop instead of a triple. But it came later on in the program, so they get bonus for putting
bonus,
it late.
But the triple salco has not a lot of points. You can have a look. What does a triple salco has a base value of? Where is it? Triple salco has a base value of 4.3 and a triple loop 4.9, and when we have the triple flip is 5.3. So you see the difference just in the base value. So it was a good decision to show it in the second half because she has a really good triple lutz. So maybe she should perform a triple flip, maybe a triple toe, but it was good. I think the most important thing often is in a show program to make no mistakes.
Well, she did just that. And this is the bit where she came up to the judges.
And really nice step sequence. And she's another young skater. She's 14 years old, you already said. And nice landings, good spins. Another happy face here in the kiss and cry area, so no crying.
There'll be no crying. Is it the lead? I don't think so.
No,
but there's a big gap between 67 of Yo Takagi and Shiki Gao of China.
I think maybe third place. That would be my thing, but could be second too.
So it's China versus Chinese Taipei.
Yeah, it's third place.
And it's third, 56-46.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It's a third place.
Of Chinese Taipei has earned 56.46 points, which brings her to third place.
Well, happy
very high
with that.
Components in that category already.
Canada 선수입니다. Representing Canada, Kaya Reuter.
Kaya Reuter. Out of Calgary, Canada. And she will be skating to I Want to Dance with Somebody.
We had a lot of great female skaters from Canada. At the moment, they're struggling a bit. But let's now look what she has in store for us. In store for us.
Clock strikes upon the hour as the sun begins to fade. Still enough time.
And so start with a triple flip, triple toe at the beginning. She's jumping clockwise.
Yeah,
so
unique. Spinning right-sided as opposed to left-sided.
It's about to look afterwards in the slow motion, because all of the jumps, so the triple toe already in the combination, now the Lutz seems like they are slightly under rotated.
Well, Kaya Reuter learned to skate with her two sisters when she was 4 years old on Ottawa's Rideau Canal. And here she is at the Winter Youth Olympic Games.
Last year, 10th at the World Juniors. And she had fun. This is nice. That's the most important thing when you're competing. No big mistakes here in this program. Let's just check the jumps. But the coach is amazed. He's fine with her performance. And of course, he can. Flip was okay. So maybe a quarter. Was good. Yeah, let's have a look. Yeah. But she laughed in her step sequence. This is always nice. And it's important. It's not just about showing the best technical elements and spins. like you said before, to play with the audience like the skater before is so important.
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah.
Now the scores. Third place, 58.78.
Yeah.
Kaya Werner of Canada has earned 58.78 points, which brings her to third place.
And I think she can be very happy with that.
Absolutely.
Representing Switzerland, Anthea Gradinaru.
Anthea Gradinaru from Switzerland.
And she plans the most difficult combination so far, triple flip with a triple loop. This is really a difficult one, so let's hope for her that she can execute it in a well manner.
And she skates to Selena Gomez, Lose You to Love Me.
You promised the world and I fell for it. I put you first and you adored it. Set fire to my forest and you let it burn. Sing off key in my chorus, 'cause it was my choice. I saw the signs and I ignored it. Rose colored glasses are distorted. Set fire to my purpose.
Yes.
Let it burn. You got off in the hurting when it wasn't yours. Yeah. We always go into it blindly. I needed to lose you to find me. This dancing was killing me slowly. I needed to hate you to love me. To love, love, to love, love. Turn me down and I'll show. And so many moments you replaced us like it was easy. Maybe they deserved it. And it's like a few.
Well, the jumps, she took on some difficult jumps there and landed them well. But then a little fall in the step sequence.
Yeah, you normally don't expect that as a skater. These are really the unexpected falls. And sometimes you're a bit overexcited and you're thinking, okay, the jumps are done, what can be happen? And then, butch, and you're on the ice. But she is smiling, that's fine.
The performance was good.
Yeah, especially the triple.
Yeah, the jumps.
This was great. Yeah.
That's the hardest combination that we've seen so far.
The triple flip normally has a base value of 5.3, the triple loop of 5 points, then in a combination even more as a base value. But this fall, of course...
Just a trip.
Yeah, and it's the deduction, of course, of 1 point at the end. But it was a really good skate for her, with a personal best of 59.24 at the moment. From her fifth place at the Junior Grand Prix in Gdansk.
So here are the scores.
Swiss Antia Gaginer 선수 55.78,
fifth place. Antia Gradinaru.
Gradinaru of Switzerland has earned 55.78 points, which brings her to fifth place. Representing Republic of Korea,
대한민국 김유성 선수입니다.
Yusong Kim of Korea is up next.
Very strong skater with a second and a fourth place in the Junior Grand Prix.
She lists her hobbies as baking. What can she cook up for this short program? Skating to Fly Me to the Moon by Sia.
Wonderful, triple flip, triple toe. Smile after the triple lutz.
Song and let me sing forevermore. Oh, you are all I long for, all
Yeah, great finish. And expect some rapturous applause.
Yeah, the ladies are really in a good mood today. What a wonderful performance. And she already had me after, I would say, 5 seconds. Without any charm, just her appearance on the ice. A very lovely attitude. And after the double axel, I thought, oh, it was not a great height. But her triple jumps, even better. So the triple-triple combination and the triple Lutz and the big smile then afterwards. And of course, even a bigger smile now today after the short program.
So she skated to fly me to the moon. Will she fly to the top of the podium?
Will we see? And you know, we have one more group, and this is the second. Yeah, the combination spins very well done too. They all are so flexible. And here the Lutz.
She seems to be so skinny as well.
She's so skinny, and yet sometimes that's the feeling.
To have that explosive power to get the jumps.
This is always incredible. I had her skated too. She was so thin. I was not expecting that she ever will execute one jump, and she was so good. She had an amazing strength.
Jusun Kim of Korea awaits the score. Current leader, Yo Takagi of Japan.
Of course, her personal best so far is a 63.04.
And that today would put her in silver.
Jusun Kim of Republic of Korea has earned 63.64.
And there we go. Silver medal so far, 63.64.
It's a PB. Absolutely okay, the second place.
And there is the scores as they stand. Yo Takagi of Japan is in the lead with Jusun Kim of Korea lying in silver with Shiki Gao of China in third. And that wraps up the group two. We're going to roll straight on with the introductions of our third and final group. So there are our final six, and the warm-up will commence.
You have 6 minutes time for your warm-up.
So let's look at the first, Ida Karunen from Finland. Skating out of Lappeenranta. Has a PB of 57.88.
Plays fifth place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Cup of Austria, representing Finland, Ida Karhunen.
Got a fifth in that Junior Grand Prix in Linz.
가족과 함께 시간을 보내기를 좋아하는 미국 선수는 미국에서 열린 주니어 그랑프리에서 3위의 성적을 거뒀습니다.
This 15-year-old skater loved calligraphy, reading,
Sherry
learning.
Shan from San Jose in California.
23 ISU Junior Grand Prix Armenian Cup, representing United States of America, Sherry Zhang.
Has a PB of 60.52.
Estonia 선수 자연과 동물을 사랑하는데요. 주니어 그랑프리 그단스과 린츠 대회에 참가했습니다.
This 14-year-old skater loves nature and animals, has placed 9th place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Cup of Austria, representing Estonia, Maria Elise Kaljaver.
Maria Elise Kaljaver, skating out of Tallinn, has a PB of 58.42 in the short program.
2023년 ISU 주니어 그랑프리 베이징 파이널 챔피언입니다.
This 15-year-old skater loves cooking.
The big favorite here.
2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Osaka, representing Japan, Mao Shimada.
Mao Shimada from Japan, born in Tokyo, now lives in Kyoto. Has a PB of 73.78.
Like already said, the world junior champion and twice junior Grand Prix final champion. But this is a strong opponent here.
Jia Shin from Korea, born in Busan, lives now in Seoul. Her PB a 71.19.
The reason why she couldn't win the Junior Grand Prix final, she was in the lead after the short program, is because she didn't show a quadruple jump and a triple axel.
And from Georgia, the final skater in this final group.
Loves figure skating and dancing. Has placed 6th place in the 2023 ISU Junior Grand Prix Armenian Cup, representing Georgia, Inga Gorjanidze.
Inga Gorjanidze, representing Georgia, born in Kazan in Russia, lives in Kazan. And the skaters will now have time to go through their warm-up and get ready for this final group. What we saw in the men's competition, that it can go wrong for the favorites.
But remember yesterday with these Ryo Nakata, the big favorite too, and then it's just one jump and then he's missing the next and things are done.
Yeah.
We saw it with Nathan Chen, the Olympic champion from 2022. He already was the big favorite at the Pyeongchang Olympics, and then he struggled with all of the three jumps. And then in the end, he was in 17th place after the short program, and no chance at all for the title.
Yeah, Ryo Nakata is lying down in 13th.
Yeah.
After yesterday's short
program. I'm sure he will show a strong performance and will jump into the top 10, maybe even top 5, but it's not what he wanted to show here. And I saw it here with her, Mao Shimada. She was in second place, like mentioned in the short program. That was a completely new situation for her. She was crying afterwards because she... But it's important for these little ladies to experience that situation too, to handle a victory, but handle, I would say, a loss too.
Well, setbacks and defeats are part of the learning process, and you learn more from mistakes than you do when things go well.
So true.
Skaters, you have 45 seconds left in your warm-up.
So not long now. The clock is ticking down on the warm-up.
Yeah, and the next skater from Finland, she had a lot of wins this season at different cups.
Warm-up 시간이 끝났습니다. 모두 퇴장하여 주시기 바랍니다. Skaters, your warm-up has ended. Please clear the ice.
So warm-up over and time to get down to business with the third and final group of this women's short program. And getting things underway will be the skater from Finland.
Finland 선수입니다. Representing Finland, Ida Karhunen.
Ida Karhunen from Finland will be skating to La Hot Jazz by Julie Andrews, composed by Henry Mancini.
Ago, way down in New Orleans, a group of fellas found a new kind of music, and they decided.
Oh, she struggled with the planned combination triple flip, triple loop, but as she didn't execute the second jump, she has the opportunity to show it. But the problem is they have to show the triple loops. No, she's not able here in the junior. In the seniors category, they are able to do that.
From Steamboat Street to La Paz. Oh, baby, waltz, oh, baby, the jazz. Maybe what's holding my soul.
Well, recovered well from a poor start, but it was disappointing that the triple loop didn't work.
Yeah, the combination. And I had in my mind, because when you're commentating a lot of competition with sinews, they are able to reschedule it if that is happening. But here, as they have to show the triple loops as a fixed element, as a required element, it's not possible. And so she lost a lot of points because it is 0 points, no base value at all because the element was not there.
But she landed the loops so well.
Yeah, but
I know
it is around 10 points without, so the it's almost 10 points, just the combination without any GOEs, this triple flip, triple loop.
What a shame.
Yeah.
And you know you've made that mistake. You might be calculating. This is the Lutz.
Yeah. But at the end, she showed it. And she showed what she is able to do.
But you got to say, a chance of a medal is gone.
Yeah, in the past we had a lot of nice Finnish skaters. Kiira Koppi, for example. She got so famous in Finland and worked as a model then afterwards.
Oh, she's putting a brave face on it.
Yeah. But you know what's in her mind.
Hmm.
The scores, please.
Finland. Ilya Karu 선수의 점수는 55.0.
7th place, 55.04.
Ida Karu of Finland has received 55.04 points.
Put these around 10 points on top. Where she would have been with this program.
Yeah.
In the top.
It would have been up amongst the top three.
Representing United States of America, Sherry Zhang.
For the United States of America, it's Sherry Zhang. And she will be skating to Vivo Tango by Maxime Rodriguez.
And the next fall in a combination should have been a triple toe, triple toe. That is the worst scenario, when you fall at the first jump of a combination. It's better when you have a fall than, of course, at the second. And another fall at the triple Lutz.
Well, could it be the pressure of starting in this final group?
Yes, and she has a very good PB with 60 points.
But just as the Finnish skater Ida Karunen did, Sherry Zhang has basically fallen on that first maneuver, fallen and
I was completely...
Big point deduction.
Yeah, and I was completely surprised because she had a nice speed and it looked like, okay, she will do that. And then that fall, and then, of course, the other fall. That's why tears are coming up. Completely understandable.
Skating out of the Glacier Falls Figure Skating Club in San Jose. They'll be watching back home.
And she had won third place in the Junior Grand Prix. She is a good skater, and then it's even more hard. Okay.
It's hard to take, isn't it, when you know that you've got it.
And I'm sure maybe the next Shortbreaker program is another perfect performance again. She has the skating abilities, and I think this is the most important thing. And this is now, okay, this was under-rotated, and she had no opportunity to land this triple Lutz. It's not just the fall, it's then the jump was not nicely landed.
What a shame.
Yeah. But it's a learning process, and she has a good talent for skating, and I'm sure she is going away.
Oh, time to put a brave face on.
Yeah.
The tears, though, are welling.
Anthony Evans, one of her coaches, is with her here.
Barely controlling our emotions. And it's 10th place, 45.97.
Sherry Zhang of United States of America.
Well, we know she's better than that. And she knows. Pick herself back up.
Estonia 선수입니다. Representing Estonia, Maria Elise Kaljaver.
Maria Elise Kaljaver from Estonia will be skating to The Summer Knows by Michael Legrand.
Triple flip, triple Lutz. Triple toe, sorry, triple flip, triple toe. Planned was a triple flip, triple loop, but it was perfect.
So the third skater in this final group, and we've had another fall, but that fall will not be as costly, Petra.
No, it was not the combination. But of course, she will get this 1 point deduction for the fall, and then normally it's a minus four or so with the GOEs.
And she has a personal best of 58. So with that in mind.
But she started
mid-50s.
Yeah. She started very strong with a triple-triple combination.
Yeah, so it's possible here for a top five or six.
And the arms extended over the head in both jumps, and that is very good for the GOE. So a lot of points here with this triple-flip, triple-toe combination.
Shiki Zhao of China sits in third with a 60.28. Don't think she's going to manage that.
Lutz was fully rotated, so she gets the whole base value. Very nice spins. Yeah, this Kaya Reuter, she had a mistake too with this 58. No, she was no mistake, but under rotation. Something around maybe 55, 56 points, maybe a bit more. But we see, because the combination was strong with the arm, so let's see. Maybe high.
Time for the scores.
Lots of soft toys here.
Fifth, 56.52, the one deduction for the fall.
Maria Lis Kaljuber of Estonia. Would have been around 60 points with a nice.
Yeah, it's just thinking what could have been, but
it's
Maria Lis Kaljuber is content with that.
Yeah, so in the race for a very good place here.
Now we get down to the favourites.
Representing Japan, Mao Shimada.
Mao Shimada from Japan has a PB of 73 and will skate to Americano by Lady Gaga and performed by Judy Jiang and Carl Hugo.
The Junior Grand Prix finals in the short programs, he stepped out at the Triple Lutz. That's why she was in the second place. And she's just 15 years old and she won so many big competitions. Reminds me a bit of another Mao, Mao Asada. She was able with 15 years to execute a triple axel too. That is not allowed here in the short program, but she can do it. We see it in the long program. Yeah, triple flip, triple toe, effortless. Normally she would have been a senior the next season. But after Beijing, everything was changed. So the minimum age for skaters will be 16 years old for this season and increased to 17 from the 24-25 season in time for the Winter Olympics in 2026. Wonderful, this triple looks. The reason is this limit will be implemented over the course of the next 3 years, and this decision was based on preserving the physical, mental and emotional health and well-being of figure skating. And I think it's the right decision. Look at this spin at the end. Incredible.
Well, there it is.
Yeah.
No problems at all.
No.
And Mao Shimada is going to, well, shake up the leaderboard. Is it good enough to go right to the top?
Definitely.
I think it is.
Definitely. We don't have to discuss about it. That this is the lead. And I think
we're going to have Japan in one and two.
And she will have points over 70. She has to be, and she will it. We'll have it. This was a really strong performance. And to be honest, on a senior level, she would have been in the top five with that performance too.
And you talk about the moving the age yeah. up to protect the young athletes,
yeah.
protect the mental health of the skaters. And the most important thing is that they're out there having fun.
Yeah.
And if it's not fun, then, you know, and you're being pressured into doing it. But it's very clear from yes. the look on her face that she is having fun and she is enjoying it.
Yes, and I really loved the quote of Eric Redford. He was third at the last at the 2018 Olympics in pair skating, and he's an athlete representative, and he said the life of an athlete is short and intense, and that's why it's even more important to raise up the minimum age. It was a clear decision, 100 to 16, so it was really, everyone wants to go this way. But that means she will be in the junior category for at least another 2 years.
And she'll dominate.
Yeah.
Potentially.
But like I said, they have so many amazing skaters in Japan. And we had often the situation that skaters like Tara Lipinski, Alina Sakitova, they won the Olympics with 14, with 15 years old, and then afterwards, we haven't heard from them anymore.
Yeah, the burnout.
Russia was very long against this decision, but now, after the Olympics, they had no quote anymore.
Well, this fantastic performance.
Yes, it was incredible. Completely amazed. Now she's smiling again. I said that she was crying after the second place at the Junior Grand Prix final, but
well, how big is...
Strong nerves today.
How big is the score?
73-78 is her personal best. Yeah,
71. It's the lead.
Yeah.
Japan are in one and two.
Mao Shimada of Japan has earned 71.0.
And she's not happy with it because... you see, look at her face. She, I think, is not happy with it.
She'll take it. She'll take it.
She's really hard on herself. In training.
Representing Republic of Korea.
But she is very good too.
Jia Shin from the Republic of Korea will get the support from the home crowd skating out of Seoul.
A very beautiful dress, my favorite one of the competition, and she's a very elegant skater. I would say maybe skating-wise, maybe better than Shimada, but when it comes to the jumps and the spins, then Shimada is amazing.
Just listen to the support. The music, Fascination, performed by Andre Rio.
That was not planned. Should have been a triple-triple, but wise decision after a very slow landing of the triple flip. Very nice, the triple lutz.
Beautiful skate, but there was that problem at the very beginning. She didn't fall, but didn't get the triple-triple. It was a triple-double, and Petra, the points will be deducted.
Yeah, around 3 points. But let's talk about her skating. Amazing. I'm completely impressed. She's so elegant. I already fell in love with her at the Junior Grand Prix final. A beautiful skater with a lovely costume and a nice attitude on the ice. And I'm sure she will be a very, very good skater in the future when she continues like that. She was in the lead in the Junior Grand Prix final after the short program. But I'm sure she would get a lot of points because she could have executed a triple, but I think she was a bit too afraid to do it.
Yeah, just it was the breaking.
Yeah, it was
scrubbed the landing.
And you have to make this decision within. It's not a second, within a moment. So it's like.
It's milliseconds.
Yeah, sometimes it's better to do it like this, because a fall would have been. Even worse, so it was at least it was a program without any falls, without any mistakes, just a triple double, another triple triple. But we see it often with the world champions too. They want to show it quadruple triple, and they decide, okay, let's make maybe a quadruple double. It's better to do it like this. I'm sure she will get high scores, especially for the components too. That we have with Moshimada with almost 8 points in the components in average.
So Moshimada sits on 71.05.
I would take
Yo Takagi 67.
It should be second or third. I would Republic put her on the second.
And third place. She pushes her teammate, Yusun King, down into fourth. With a 66.48. Just behind Yo.
I'm a bit surprised with the components. I would have given her a bit more with the components. That's why I thought maybe it could be the second place too. But it's okay.
Representing Georgia, Inga Gurkanidze.
Last skater already.
Yes, representing Georgia, Inga Gurkanidze. The last to take to the ice here in this Gangwon Ice Arena. And she will be skating to Winter from Four Seasons by Vivaldi.
Thank you.
Wow. That was a combination, the height of this triple flip and then the triple toe. Incredible. I saw it just when she left. That is... Oh, I really hope for a nice triple Lutz because her jumps are so incredible. She could have jumped into the top three.
Wow, no question of Inga Gurkanidze's ability and the speed on the ice and the
amazing beauty
of the performance, but the fall.
Oh, you see, she's almost about to cry, and I can totally understand it because until this triple Lutz, until this fall, it was impressive what she did. I would say the best combination of the competition, and I hope we see it again in the slow motion because the height and you mentioned the speed on the ice. And this is so important. And when you are live in the hall, it's even faster than we see it on screen.
Yeah.
Look at this combination. What? You don't have to discuss was it fully rotated or not.
No.
Same with the axle.
Yeah.
Completely easy. Nice spins too.
Well, she'll be ruining
wonderful
what could have
posture.
Been. This is the Lutz.
Yeah, complete out of the axis. She had no opportunity to land this Lutz.
If it hadn't been for that one mistake.
But she will get more points than the other one who had the four with the triple Lutz. Because the jump combination had another level, another quality. She will... for sure gets, I would say, more than 3 points of GOEs on top for this combination. And level four spins. So let's wait and see. Top five for sure, but where? Not top three, but I think, now we see. Because on third place is the Korean guy, no. Then she is, yeah. Shin is in third place, so I think...
Here we go. Here's the scores. And it's seventh place, 57.99. So disappointment for Inga Gurkanidze of Georgia.
It's the components. It's the components.
And the
she
deduction.
Lost it with, yeah, but she lost it with the components. Because we had components over 30. We're the big skaters.
Oh, disappointment for Inga Gurkanidze. Yeah. But look at this. We've got Japan in first and second. Mao Shimada in 71.05.
Two Koreans then,
Takagagi,
yeah.
And then the two Koreans, Jia Shin and Yusung Kim. It's looking very good for the long program, which will come and take place in a couple of days' time.
Just one Canadian, and we have five skaters from Asia in the top five.
Yeah.
But it will be nice. I'm really looking forward to the free skate in 2 days.
Yeah, well, I hope you've enjoyed it, and tune in again tomorrow.